More complex splitting occurs when a proton has two different kinds of neighbors, and a good example of this is the blue proton that I circled in cinnamaldehyde. So the blue proton has a signal with a chemical shift about 6.7 parts per million. So down here is a zoomed in view of the signal for the blue proton. Let's look at neighboring protons. So the blue proton is on this carbon, and we have a carbon next door right here with one proton, so there's one neighboring proton. Here's another carbon next door with one proton, so we have two neighboring protons. So let's try to apply the n plus 1 rule here. So if n is equal to 2, we have two neighboring protons, we would expect n plus 1 peaks. So 2 plus 1 is equal to 3, so a signal with 3 peaks or a triplet. But that's not what we see for the signal for the blue proton. We see 1, 2, 3, 4 lines here. So the n plus 1 rule doesn't work in this case, and that's because the n plus 1 rule works when the neighboring protons are equivalent, and here the two neighboring protons are not equivalent. So we need a new way to explain the signal for the blue proton, and we're going to use what's called a splitting tree. So we're going to start with the signal for the blue proton. So here's the signal for the blue proton. It's going to be split by the proton next to it, this proton in red. And the coupling constant between the red and the blue proton is 12 hertz. So let's go ahead and show. Let's show this signal is split into a doublet. All right, so let me go ahead and draw in the blue lines here. So we get the signal split into a doublet. The coupling constant is 12 hertz. So this distance here represents 12 hertz. So why can we think about it being split into a doublet? Well, you could think about a variation of the n plus 1 rule here, right? So we're talking about one neighboring proton. So n is equal to 1. N is equal to 1. So 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So we split the signal into a doublet with two lines. All right, now let's think about what happens with the other proton. So this one. Okay, well that's going to take each line of the doublet that we just drew and split it into another doublet. So this line gets split into a doublet, and this line gets split into a doublet. The coupling constant this time is 6 hertz, right? So this distance here represents 6 hertz, and this distance represents 6 hertz. So why was each line split into two? Well, once again, we can use a modification of the n plus 1 rule here. All right, so we're talking about one neighbor here, so n is equal to 1, so 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, so each line is split into 2, all right, so each line is split into a doublet for this line and for this line is split into a doublet too. So we get four lines for the signal of the blue proton. If we go over here, we see those four lines, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And we call this a doublet of doublets, or a double doublet. All right, what would happen if the coupling constants were the same? So let's just pretend like they're both 12 hertz. So let's go ahead and draw what we would see for the signal. So we have our blue proton's signal is split into a doublet by the red proton. So let's go ahead and draw in our doublet here. And let's say this distance represents 12 hertz, right? So 12 hertz here. And let's say the coupling constant over here, right, was also 12 hertz, so instead of 6 hertz. So each line of the doublet we just drew is split into another doublet from our other neighbor. And this time I'm going to show a coupling constant of 12 hertz. All right, so each line of the doublet in blue is split into another doublet. So the line in blue on the left is split into a doublet, and the line in blue on the right is split into a doublet, right, because of our one neighboring proton. All right, well, I changed the coupling constants. Now I said to pretend like now we're dealing with 12 here, right? So the coupling constants are the same. And notice what this gives us. This gives us a triplet, right? So here is one line, and then we're going to get this peak, and then we're going to get this peak here. So if the coupling constants are the same, you get a triplet. You get what the n plus one rule predicted. And so that's just something to think about with the origin of the n plus one rule. Let's do another example, all right? So let's go down here. And let's look at this molecule. So we're gonna focus in on this proton here in blue. All right, and we have neighboring protons, right? So this neighboring proton, the coupling constant between those two is 12 hertz. And then over here, we have two neighboring protons, and the coupling constant between the magenta protons and the blue is 7 hertz. So let's think about the signal for the blue proton here. So here we have the signal for the blue proton, which isn't split. Let's think about what the red proton is going to do. We have one neighbor, right? So 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So we're going to split the signal for the blue proton in 2. So we get a doublet here. So let me go ahead and draw on the doublet. The coupling constant was 12 hertz. So this distance right here is 12 hertz. All right, now we have a situation where we're thinking about the magenta protons, and we have two of them, right? So n is equal to 2, so 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. So the magenta protons are going to split each line of the doublet that we just drew into a triplet. All right, so we're going to get a triplet here. Let me go ahead and draw that in. So for a triplet, and our coupling constant is 7 hertz. So let me see if I can draw that here. So that distance is supposed to represent 7 hertz. So let me draw that in. All right, so this distance is 7 hertz. This distance corresponds to 7 hertz. And one line of our doublet is split into a triplet now. Same thing happens for the other line, right? Same thing happens for this line right here. We need to split that into a triplet because of these magenta protons, right? So we're going to split that into a triplet. Once again, we need to think about a distance of 7 here, 7 hertz. So we have on both sides, we have 7 hertz. So let me go ahead and draw that in. So this is talking about 7 hertz. And this is talking about 7 hertz. So that one line is split into a triplet. So let's draw that in here. 1, 2, and 3. So finally, how many peaks would we expect for the signal for this blue proton? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we would expect 6 peaks for the signal for this blue proton because of the neighboring protons, which are in different types of environments. So this is complex splitting.